manna that comes from heaven kept the children of Israel for 40 years. Except those who transgressed, there was none of them that died prematurely. Except those that God had marked himself. The devil could not destroy them. Sickness could not destroy them. And this book, the manna that we have been given, that has fed us, this church used to be known. In fact, even some ministers, they will say, well, we know that church is a church of the word. But if we feel at this point in our lives that the doctrine, the word is no more relevant, and some people are going on the television, reading strange books, listening to strange messages of people who are going to tell them things that are not in the Bible, revelations that you cannot find in Scripture, dreams, things that will not feed the soul, but rather weaken the soul and bring defeat, messages that exalt the devil and downplay the power of the Almighty God. There is no way we are going to succeed that way. That is why revival is necessary of pure doctrine. In verse 14, but I have a few things against thee, because thou hast there them that hold the doctrine of Balaam, who taught Balak to cast a stumbling block before the children of Israel, to eat things sacrificed to idols, and to commit fornication. Verse 15, so hast thou also them that hold the doctrine of the Nicolaitans, which thing? What did Jesus say? I hate. Verse 16. Repent, or else I will come unto thee quickly and fight against them with the sword of my mouth. Sometimes there is a problem in a particular church and the people don't know that it is God fighting against them. And they will be praying, deliver us from the devil. If you throw away the doctrine, and the church goes away from understanding, from reading the Bible, and from interpreting the scriptures, and from saying, this is the word of God, and all we are now looking at is, I want to tell you about the dreams that I have dreamt, the visions that I have seen, and we do not read the plain scripture anymore. I will tell you something. I will give you another light to the law and to the testimony. If they speak not according to this word, it is because there is no light in them. There is no other light that you are going to see. The word of God is very plain to him who loves the truth. Thou shalt not commit adultery. How do we interpret that? Jesus has given us the interpretation. If you look at a woman to lust after that woman, he has committed adultery already in your heart. And people will come and turn that and say, I have another light. Which other light do you want to show us? That light is not going to raise strong believers. That light is not going to raise people who are able to overcome the devil. Because in 1 John chapter 2, the Bible tells us that those young men, they are strong because the word of God abides in them. And because of that, they overcome the wicked one. If every one of us begin to run around. You know, we have been talking about mental health, which is important. And I see that happening practically all over the Western world, in the Western church, in our church. But may I tell you that if we are not going to obey the scripture, if you are not going to go back and find out how God deals with mental health in the scriptures, and everything that we are looking at is the science, the technology, and the everything, eventually what happens to them in the world will be happening to us. There is nothing wrong about medical science, of course. There's nothing wrong. But if everything about our health, if all that we do about our health, including mental health, is what the other people can find as resources in the world, why are we Christians? What gives us the edge? Then we should never be surprised if what happens to them outside also happens to us. After all, when we are talking about internal diseases and other diseases, we still go to God for healing. We go to the hospital. We do everything. But we don't limit ourselves to those things. We still ask the Lord because He has said that He's going to bless our bread and water and He's going to take sicknesses away from us. When it comes to mental health, why not? In fact, that is even a gray area because those areas, medical science doesn't understand all of them. Many times there is no clue. There are helps we can get here and there, but we will be doing ourselves a world of evil if we limit ourselves. Because God says in His word, God has not given you the spirit of fear, but of power, of what? Of love, and what? Of a sound mind. And I can take that back to God and say, God, this is what you have done. This is what you have said. You have not given me all these kind of things that harass me. And I take it back to God. I get all the help I can get. But I go back to God and I say, God, you have said you have given me a sound mind. And a sound mind I'm going to have. And on every area of your life, marriage is important. But if we limit ourselves to the marriage counselors outside there in the world, then what happens to other marriages will be happening to us. But if we are going to God and say, God, you are the therapist. You are not even the therapist, you are the healer. I am having a problem. I'm having a difficulty. What has God told us? You will search in the book of God and we are going to find answers in Jesus' name. Our own answers, our own victory will be greater than they have in the world. Amen. The same thing, you know, we can learn a lot about how to be successful in business. And I will say, well, this, win-win situation and all these other things, assertiveness and all those kind of things, wonderful. But may I tell you that there are principles in scriptures that our fathers have used. And in fact, some of these Western nations that we are seeing, they have built on those principles and they have brought them victory and wealth. If we are going to limit ourselves to the things that we find in the world and we neglect the scriptures, then what happens to those people outside will be happening to us. The Bible says the riches, the blessings of God, what happens? They make rich. And there's an element there, he will not add sorrow. The thing that brings burnout, the thing that brings sorrow, the thing that when people become successful, they even divorce their partners, the thing that brings headache and stress, all those things should not be happening in our midst because there is revival of pure doctrine. And that's why we need to go back to the scriptures. Don't throw away the Bible. Find out principles of success. Find out principles of achievement. Find out principles how you are going to succeed. Find out how your prayer will be answered. When you pray according to the scriptures, God will answer. If somebody is going to tell you that I have another secret, you can just pray. Just leave the Bible alone. Just go and pray and shake your head. God is going to answer. It is witchcraft. It's occultism. Because the Bible says, he who turns away his ear from hearing the law, what will happen to his prayer? It will be abomination. I will pray the scriptures into being in my life. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of the Lord. If you want to see a man that is praying, look at Moses. That will bring the... Well, after receiving revelation from God, which is in the Bible, we have seen it, he brought it back to God. He said, God, you have told me that you are the merciful God, you are forgiven iniquity, and that will by no means clear the guilty. And he brought that back to God. God, you have said this one, and God said, I have pardoned according to thy word. Those are the people that know pure doctrine. We're not going to be saying, well, what with this Bible? We have been reading the Bible. We have been doctrine. It doesn't help us. It's helping us. That's why we are still standing in the faith. That's why we are still standing in the world. That's why we are still standing and the devil has not succeeded in crushing us. That's why all through the corona years, when some churches, literally they packed up, God is still keeping the church because we are built on his word. If you honor the word of God, God is going to honor you. In a time of trouble, in a time of difficulty, well, if you build your house on the solid rock, it's going to stand and you are not going to be shaken in Jesus' name. That's why you see some people, they travel from Africa and other places and they come here and then we see them and they say, let me find the church. They don't backslide. People who are built on the word of God, they will not backslide. You will not be among them that go back in Jesus' name. Yeah.